As far as the merits of the bill is, I'll come to Mr. Anna Hazare in a moment. As far as the merits of the bill is concerned, let me answer both Mr. Hazare and Ms. Kiran Bedi together. It's very important to remember, first of all, that the government has said that we are prepared to discuss the 5 or 6 major amendments or changes you propose in the bill. What is the problem? The problem is twofold. Mr. Arvind Kejriwal and others have said that we will not discuss it unless and until the drafting or the finalization of the bill is done by a joint committee of the government and of civil society persons. Now, let me clarify that this is a kind of a threshold obstruction, and on that Mr. Hazare has also gone on a fast. There is no procedure where a precedent can be set by the government. Like it or not, it's a very dangerous precedent in parliamentary democracy. Very respected Mr. Hazare and Mr. Arvind Kejriwal are, however, not ministers and not elected representatives. Only they have the right to take the political flag. They are the political executive, and they have to draft the bill. Just one second. Please let me complete, Arnab. You've got lots of views there. They are welcome to give input.
I have specific
questions. But what they're saying is there must be virtually a joint drafting committee. And that has become a threshold objection. Today, the political flag has to be faced by the government, and the government can't abdicate or give up its responsibility by saying, however high eminent and however valuable situations, that we will involve civil society members in a group of ministers to do the actual decision making.
Take away the argument of civil society members.
Thirdly,
take away the argument of civil society members, but I have a specific point to you, sir. Specific point, sir.
Let me come one by one, please. Arnab, let me finish your specific point. I'm not finished your specific point.
Sir,
your third specific point was what Kiran Bedi raised.
Sir, specific.
She said that this is an advisory recommendatory bill. Now, let me tell you that apart from the fact that the 2001 and the earlier versions were all recommendatory, this is a major issue to be discussed. I am not ruling it out, but personally, there are several good reasons why it must remain recommendatory.
If it's recommendatory,
if it's recommendatory,
that's the argument. How do you want, tomorrow you want a bill like this to be enforced to be able to act against anyone?
It.
The KG Balakrishnans, Rajas, Kalmadis.
If you'll permit me.
Argument is this. One second, Abhishek,
I have a question.
Now let me ask one question, which you and Abhishekar Prasad can answer. Either of you can answer. How can the Lokpal be reduced to a toothless body with no real powers? Why have a Lokpal?
It's not a toothless body, please. Please, since when have you... This is all jingoism on television. There is nothing which makes it toothless. If a Lokpal, which is a high-powered central body, gives a recommendation that X, Y, Z is culpable or guilty, it has huge moral pressure. It has huge force. It cannot bind the political executive.
Sir, this Lokpal will not have jurisdiction.
Is binding.
This Lokpal will not have jurisdiction against officers, judges and bureaucrats. That's a fact. The proposed Lokpal that your government is pushing through. Let Kiran Bedi respond. Kiran Bedi is responding.
I am not answering that question.
It excludes.
So you are jumping from point to point. When I answer one point, you go to the next point.
The present UN bill excludes bureaucrats. It excludes judges. It excludes bureaucrats and judges. It does not. The point is, you're very right. And it's just again a limited body. It's not a multi body. It's again going to be politically influenceable. That's exactly the problem with the CBI. In fact, the country does not have an independent anti-corruption authority. It needs one independent anti-corruption authority, like the CEC, like the CAG, like the Supreme Court. This is what it needs today. I want to ask them, what do you want? Do you want corruption to fall, or do you want the corruption to thrive? What do you want?
My question to Ravi Shankar Prasad.
Then you bring in the GUM.
My question to Ravi Shankar Prasad is, Ravi Shankar Prasad, you were at the forefront of the P.J. Thomas affair. Tell me, I'm simply asking about the selection of the Lokpal. Like Kiran Bedi want, they want the selection committee from members of the judicial background, the chief election commissioner, international awardees, distinguished Indians, you know, that's what they want. But you, the bill you brought in and the bill the Congress is pushing, wants that committee to be comprised of politicians. After the P.J. Thomas affair, you still have faith in that process of selection.
Arnab, the first thing I must tell you today, I don't wish to politicize this debate. And I don't want to be provoked in spite of what Abhishek is saying. But one thing I will take a serious offense to, calling us irresponsible is responsibility the sole prerogative of Congress party? This language of emergency days, I regret to say, needs to be condemned strongly. Abhishek, we are responsible people believing in the democracy of India, and you have got no right to give me certificates about irresponsibility. And I completely condemn it outright. Now, coming to the points Arnav you are raising, it is all the kind of people you appoint. After all, we have got so many election commissioners, except barring one, two, they have done a good job in the last 15, 20 years. We have so many
CVPs
by the same process who have...
But they are independent.
Madam Kiran
Bedi. Okay, let him complete.
Kiran Bedi, I did not interrupt you, Kiran Bedi. Please wait for your turn. Apart from Mr. Thomas, others have been doing a good job. After all, so many CAGs have done a very good job. Therefore, you cannot make a blanket kind of an observation that political appointment or political process per se leads to malafide appointment or wrong appointment. If Mr. Thomas was there, the pressure of media, the opposition, and finally the intervention of court is also a part of democratic process. Having said that, what I am trying to highlight today, if there are certain good points in the Jan Lokpal Bill, the government should be open to take that on board. Yes, the BJP is very clear that the Lokpal Bill has to become an effective and credible instrument. Yeah. And the bureaucrats also must be covered,
yes,
apart from political leaders.
Because Abhishek Manu Singhvi, you know, you accused me of jingoism when I spoke of the specific points. I have one specific question to you, very specific. As per your proposal, the Lokpal will not have the power to initiate action suo moto in any case or receive complaints of corruption from the general public. The general public will send complaints to the Speaker of the Lok Sabha or the Chairperson of the Rajya Sabha. Only those complaints forwarded by the Speaker or the Chairperson will be investigated by the Lokpal. So at the first stage itself, there's total political control. So, you know, your Speaker and Chairperson is from the ruling party. If you don't give the powers to suo moto investigate, tomorrow the Speaker can say, you know what, I don't think Kalmadi is a serious case. I don't think Raja is a serious case. That's not jingoism, Abhishek Manu Singhvi. That's denying civil society their rights.
No, you are. You see, you've never talked to this topic earlier. As I answered one question, Let's be on the specific point. First of all, as far as suo moto is concerned, or the modality of filing a complaint, I am repeating on your television camera openly, these are certainly open for discussion. They can be modified. This is only a draft proposal. There is no rigid, inflexible, cast in stone situation. However, please see the other side. There is a lot of merit in some structures. These are filtering safeguards put. Because both bureaucrats and politicians and individuals who take decisions, who you must haul up if they are corrupt or bad,
so
equally have to take decisions which displace one party or the other.
They
have to be insulated. Can I complete? Can I please complete? Please. You've got four people, three plus yourself.
I've asked at least one fourth
of the time.
It's very specific point.
Four
yes.
people there, please.
Yes.
I'm answering with a specific point. How more specific can I get? This is a necessary filter to prevent false, frivolous, vexatious, malafide prosecution.
So why does the filter have to be of politicians?
I say no on merit.
Why can't the
denying.
Filter? No, why can't the filter
decision.
Be say of Kiran
you
Bedi?
Say, I'll haul you up. I'll haul you up before the Lokpal.
No, why does the filter have to be a political filter? Why does the filter have to be a political filter?
I told you, these can be discussed. It is entirely possible that the final draft may include a suo moto. I'm not saying no to it. But please understand, it is not so simple to say that a report of the Lokpal must be always binding. Lokpal is also a human being. By making it binding on the political executive of the country, you are giving, in fact, parliamentary democracy away to the Lokpal.
Okay, we are going to
if a Lokpal makes a report, even if it's recommendatory, it has very great weight, moral weight, actual weight.
How much power a Lokpal needs to
and
be given, we'll discuss.
Have a filter. You but must protect people against false, frivolous, vexatious complaints.
Therefore, you must rightly provide
for prosecution of those people who try to blackmail you.
Kiran Bedi, I'm going to come back to you because you're staying back after the break. But because Ravishankar Prasad is going away right now, I'm just asking one question, Mr. Prasad. You know, tonight itself on this program, I have both of you gentlemen representing the Congress and the BJP. What is the real problem? Can't you come together and agree to what Anna Hazare is saying? Let's have a committee. Not a committee of politicians. He said, I don't want Sharad Pawar on the committee. Not a political committee. I want a committee involving civil society members, etc., to talk to the government. I mean, what's the real problem? Can't you come together and agree to that? Or will this drag?
Arnav, first of all, as far as dialogue with their committee is concerned, We have always said the government must ensure that dialogue takes place. On behalf of my party, our stand is very clear. If there are certain good features in the Jan Lokpal bill, that ought to be taken on board. Therefore, today you must have seen my comment, which I have said, I repeat it here. The government must ensure an all-party dialogue also.
Okay.
On their proposal, another proposal.
Okay.
Because we must understand that the people of the country want swift action. We must respect the wish of the people of the country.
Okay.
That we need to understand.
I think that's
because the corruption has acquired cancerous proportion.
Okay. I think that is extremely significant. That's an important point. And Kiran Bedi, please stay on with us. But, you know, as I thank Abhishek Manu Singhvi and Ravi Shankar Prasad, what I find extremely interesting is that one person's fast today has brought this matter to an inflection point. Clearly, there is something seething within all of us. I'm coming back to the subject in 2 minutes. And I also have a young student joining the panel tonight, because Young India is also coming out. Malika Sarabhai is joining the panel tonight. Kiran Bedi is staying with us. Keep in mind, this is not just another fast.